Hello and welcome to the Lily Mercer Show. I'm here with Tinashe.
Hi.
And is there an album to come? Because obviously Two-On wasn't on Blackwater, so...
Yes, I'm working on the debut album right now. I actually started working on that in 2013. So that is one of the projects that has taken me a very long time to complete. But for me, I was just... It was definitely a learning experience going from doing all the stuff myself in my room and just writing it all and making it all myself to then collaborating with different producers and, you know, working out of different major studios. So it's been an amazing learning process, but I've recorded about 100 more songs, so we definitely have a lot to choose from.
Wow, that's going to be a hard choice, I bet.
Yes, definitely. Maybe do it in the back. Sweat is marijuana, keep it crack. Lights, camera, action. I ain't doing nothing to the cash.
Money, 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 we fashion. Draped up and dripped out, keep the trees passing. And a lot of the songs that we've heard, you featured a lot of really talented rappers on. You know, some of the kind of, you know, up and coming artists like Travis Scott.
Yes.
And others as well, like Schoolboy Q. So is that like your kind of, is that your second favorite genre after maybe R&B?
Yeah, so probably. I'm also really into like alternative music. Like I love like... Little Dragon, Metric, Yeah Yeah Yeahs, James Blake. So I have a lot of different sides to me, and I like to pull influence from, you know, different genres of music. But it's been really great to just collaborate with different people in hip hop and have, you know, the cosign of people wanting to get on my tracks like Chance the Rapper and Travis Scott and Schoolboy Q and all those people. So it's fun.
And are you, you've been recording, obviously, Blackwater. That was recorded within 2 weeks in your house.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I
great
really
project for that.
Yeah, I'm like, when I get in a zone or like a vibe, it's really hard for me to like lose focus. So I kind of just like hone in on something and I can really turn it around quickly. So a couple of my mixtapes I actually made like in less than a month. So yeah, most of them, all three of them I made in a relatively short period of time, so... It's interesting.
And you've also experimented in acting, really. You've done
yes,
a lot of acting
yeah.
Since the age of five. So is that something that you think that you'll return to, or is it just music?
Yeah, I mean, I plan to eventually really kind of get back into it, especially if it's like a really good role or something that really I feel like challenges me as an actress. But I definitely just wanted to take a step back from it for a few years just to establish that I was serious about the music thing. So when I was about 15, I really kind of went on hiatus, if you will, so that, you know, people knew that music wasn't just something I was trying to do for fun. It was something that I'm really passionate about and really want people to know me as Tinashe, the artist, the music artist.
Because you were in a group before as well, so people do actually know you from being in a group.
Yes.
But it seems that you've got like a really independent streak. So was that something that from day one you kind of knew it was a stepping stone rather than career?
Yeah, absolutely. I think I always had in the back of my mind the plans of being a solo artist. And at the time when I joined the group, I was 14. So I felt like I was still a little bit young to really dive into pursuing my full career. So I was like, hey, I'll try this out for a few years and see what comes of it. And it was a really great learning experience. And, you know, we got to really get my feet wet in the industry and just, you know, feel really comfortable.
And also dropping out of school at, was it 14?
Yeah.
That's very, very brave. Like, you clearly already knew that you would probably make it somewhere.
Yeah, I'm the type of person that only, you know, it's all plan A. There's no plan B. So for me, I always knew what I wanted to do. I was super confident in that. And I think my parents were super confident in that as well. So after ninth grade, I was like, hey, I don't want to go to school anymore. So I just tested out. I got all my credentials. It was like, peace. And that was that.
And will there be any more exciting collaborations coming? Or can we
yes.
even expect a freestyle from you? Because there are actually some yeah. kind of rap styles, you know, on Stunt, for example.
I like to integrate that into my music, you know. I'm definitely, just as a creative person in general, like to, like I said, take inspiration from the different genres that inspire me. And hip-hop being one of them, I like to be able to, you know, have rap moments on the album as well. But yeah, there's a couple exciting features on the album that like I'm looking forward to. I have a song with ASAP Rocky that's coming out soon that I'm excited about, and then also one that I did with Future. So it'll be fun.
Sounds exciting. So yeah, lots more to come from you later on this year.
Lots more to come.
Oh, well, it was lovely to talk to you, and thank you very much for joining me on the Lily Mercer Show.
Yes, thank you so much. It's happy to be here.